Maranatha, my PBC family and friends. Today we're going to be looking at a proverb, and it's actually one that speaks directly to my heart this morning. This morning I just kind of got one of those high-volume, low-value discussions with my wife because of just silliness, honestly. I mean, that's the best word I could put, just plain silliness, just over stupid things, things that ultimately at the end of the world and the end of time don't matter. And so I was reminded of a proverb this morning in Proverbs chapter 12, and I want to just say, I'm going to read verse 18 to begin, and then I'm going to go from there. It says, "There is that speaketh like the piercings of a sword, but the tongue of the wise is health." And so what I thought was interesting about this is there's something that can honestly just people say, and we know this, right? People will say something, or you'll say something, and you know you're using it like a sword. You're wielding it to try to hurt somebody. Instead of actually just letting it be, as it says here, a healing tongue. Something that, and honestly, what is the healing tongue? Well, what does the healing tongue look like? Well, he actually answers that question for us, right? He says this. He says in verse 16, to pick up the kind of the flavor of what he's talking about here, he says, "A fool's wrath is presently known, but a prudent man covereth shame." Here's the point. A fool speaks quickly. And that's what brings out that sword. That's what makes that piercing, because there's no thought to it. They're just immediately reacting, gut reactions to the flesh or whatever the case may be. And we always talk about, well, what's your gut reaction? Yeah, 9 times out of 10, your gut reaction is the wrong reaction. But he says here, "The fool's wrath is presently known." You're going to know it right off the bat. "But a prudent man covereth shame." In other words, a wise man, as he would say, a prudent man, because he goes on and talks about this being a wise man, is the man who would what? Sit there for a minute, think about what's going on, think about what's being said, and then finally, when he does speak, bring about that health, that what is the right answer. "He that speaketh truth," verse 17 says, "showeth forth righteousness, but a false witness deceit." Here's the point. When we stop and we think about what we're about to say, James even warns us about this. When we stop and think about this and we control that tongue, then we're going to have what? Truth come out of it. Whereas if we just speak harshly, rashly, quickly, like a fool, there's no truth in it usually. I mean, even though it may be a true feeling that you have, it doesn't mean it's a right feeling you have, and truth in accordance to God's word. So my point of this morning is very simple for us. Let's take an account for our words. Let's stop and think about what we're about to say. Let's not just open our mouth and let the tongue wag. Let's let it literally sit in our mouth long enough that we can think through things rather than reacting to things. Because when we react to things, what we end up doing is saying things that honestly are just swords. And those swords cut. And though the wounds may heal, the scars may remain. And we have to let the Lord deal with those things as well. But the point of the matter is what I want to say is this. Our God is truth. If we could stop and just reflect upon things with the Lord instead of trying to figure things out ourselves, ask God to give us wisdom and understanding in these things, and then just trust Him for the decisions that He should give you or what He should say to you, assuming it's not in disobedience to His word, then go forth with confidence, knowing that God's got this. So I hope this encourages you this morning. I know it encourages me. I love you. We love you. God loves you. And God's got this.